Cathay Pacific, which is the flagship carrier of Hong Kong. There was the CEO is stepping down this morning on pressure from the Chinese government. There he is there, Rupert Hogg, coming up, being accused of being a little bit too sympathetic to the protesters, not cracking down on his employees quick enough. Shows you the amount of power that Beijing has over an independently held company like Cathay Pacific to pressure them to make this executive step down. So his resignation in the news this morning. Also, Disney drawn into this fight. There's calls to boycott its new blockbuster movie, Mulan. It's not even out yet. The lead actress tweeted her support of the Hong Kong police, not the protesters. And Mulan is a story of a Chinese maiden rising up against the odds. But now there's calls to boycott Mulan. So that draws Disney, a multi-billion dollar movie potentially. Another example here is Korean boy band GOT7. They're forced to cancel their shows later this month and into September. One member came out saying that he supported the Chinese flag as a Chinese flag bearer, and in fact being against the protesters. So there's lots of emotions on either side of this argument. If you come out on side of the protesters, get ready to suffer the wrath of the Chinese government. And the other side of the equation, come out on the side of the Chinese government, get ready to suffer the wrath of potentially your public with your shows.
On the bigger level, even bigger level, as I said, global economic hub, and there are concerns about the effects of that. I mean, we're heading into the 11th weekend of protests.
Yes, huge.
Increasing concerns about some form of crackdown potentially looming. What larger effect on Hong Kong could there be?
Yeah, it's a financial hub, and it's getting hurt. It's already the economy's hurting because of the global war between the U.S. and China. But the airport tourism represents about 5% of this economy. There's 29 million tourists in Hong Kong just last year. And so with the Chinese military exercising potential control of crowd demonstrations, not good for tourism. But beyond that, there was a flat quarter. Beyond that, there's $2.4 billion stimulated from the Hong Kong government to get the economy going. So lots of attention being paid to this, particularly with this, they call it a pillar of the economy, which is tourism. And if tourists are being scared away, it's really bad for Hong Kong in general.
Okay, going to continue watching that aspect of the story for us. Scott, thank you very much.